William Shakespeare is probably the most famous writer in history. Shakespeare plays are read and performed all over the world. Even though he wrote them during the time of the Tudors and the reign of James I. William Shakespeare was born in Stratford-upon-Avon in 1564. It is thought that he was born on quite close to 23rd April. His father John was a glove maker and he was an important and well-respected resident of Stratford, and his mother came from a wealthy farming family. William probably went to the local
when William Shakespeare was about 13, his father experienced some money problems and got into debt. It is thought that William left school at this point in order to help his father run the family business and generate more income. Very little is known about William Shakespeare until his marriage in 1582. Shakespeare wasn't famous at this point, so he is not mentioned in any written source from the Tudor period. In 1582, Shakespeare married Anne Hathaway. She was the daughter of the local farmer and was 8 years older than Shakespeare. Anne and William had a child called Susanna in 1583. In 1585, they had twins Hamnet and Judith. William and Anne and their three children lived in Shakespeare's parents in Stratford in about 1587. Shakespeare moved to London. It is not known exactly. Hello everyone, let's begin our second chapter of course book, that is The Tempest from the New Broadways. The Tempest is one of the last plays written by Shakespeare. This is the story of The Tempest, set in 15th century on the Mediterranean island. The story describes how magic helps to right an old wrong. This is the story of little magic and how with the help of magic we can turn something wrong and we can turn over it in right. This is really very interesting story, so listen it carefully and try to understand it. A violent storm was raging over the island. Violent is called very harsh, very horrible storm is called very fast wind or very heavy rain. Okay, raging over is called reaching over. Island is a piece of land with three sides water. So this is the story of island which was between of the sea, and too much heavy storm was coming on the island. On a beach not far from the mouth of his cave stood Prospero the wizard. Now at the side of the beach, beach means at the bank of a sea, there was a land, and at the bank of the beach, so there was a man near the cave. As you know, cave is a place where a lion lives. So near a cave a man was standing. His name was Prospero. He was a wizard. Wizard is called a magician. His white hair and beard streaming out in the wind. Now that man is having white beard, white hair and streaming out is called moving in the air, means he is having very long beard, very long hair, and also having very very heavy wind was blowing. The black ropes flapping around him. Now he was wearing a black robe. Robe is, you might be have seen the king dress of the king with a big cloth back of him, and with when he is walking, it crawl around the floor. In simple sentence, a very long cloth worn by the king in their net, and that cover the whole body, the full body when they walk. As he raised his left hand, thunder rumbled. Now he was a magician. Okay, as he took his left hand up, thunder rumbled. thunder is the lightning in the sky with a loud sound, whereas rumble is called very deep sound. That sound was very deep, very loud. So as he raised his left hand, there was a huge sound in the sky. He lifted the staff in rigging and had a forked lightning crackled, flickering snake's tongues across the inky cloud. So when he was taking this stuff, in the sense stick, as you know, the magician has a stick. He just pointed the stuff towards the sky. Then what happens? Little lightning lines in the sky with its huge sound was there. All the lightning in the sky was looking at the forked snakes. This means, as you know, what is fork? Yes, we eat Chinese food such as noodles, pasta, cake, etc. And snake's tongue means, as the snake removes its tongue, we see that its snake is a splitter in two parts. As I told you that the story is divided into two parts, so today we are going to see just the first part. Let us see what is there in the first part. Out at sea, ship with broken mast and tattered sails rolled about helplessly as the storm drove it towards a jagged coral reef. As Prospero was standing at the beach or at the bank of the sea, he sees a big ship which was sailing and with mast and tattered means torn cloth hanging in the ship, and mast is called a type of anchoring sign, a very tall structure which makes the ship to look very high. The ship was rolled about helplessly means the ship was not having the balance and it has lost its way because of the heavy wind and storm. A lovely young woman in a white gown hurried out of the cave and ran towards Prospero, her dark hair whipping about her face. That means a beautiful girl was standing near there with a white gown, and she was going towards the Prospero. Her dark hair whipping about her face means she was having long hairs because of the heavy wind and storm. All the hairs were on her face. She caught the wizard by the sleeves and called out, "Father." She held the Prospero's hand and said him, sleeve. What is sleeves? What you wear for your shirt on the hand, that is called a sleeve. And called him father. Prospero seemed not to hear her. His eyes stayed firmly fixed on the ship. Though she was calling him father, Prospero was not listening to him as he was continuously staring at the ship. Father shouted, "Young woman, what are you doing? Everyone aboard that ship will be killed." The young the woman who was there, she was shouting for the father, but that not to go the near the ship. Above the sound of the wind came a groaning crash of timber striking rock. A huge wave reared up like a startled horse and thundered down on the ship, making it vanish from sight. As there was a heavy wind and storm, there was the sound of a groaning crash of timber. Timber in the sense it is made up of wood. The ship was made up of wood, and there was a sound of that, and started horse and thundered down on the ship. It was making vanish from the sight. Prospero lowered his hand. The wind dropped to a gentle breeze and the sun glinted on a calm sea. He raised his hand and there was a thunder and raised his hand towards the sky and there was a thunder and rumbled in the sky. Now he has lowered his hand, that means he has put his hand down. Now after that the wind drops to a gentle breeze. It was like a storm. Now it has come down and the sun glinted on a calm sea. "No one has been harmed, Miranda," said Prospero. "Everything is as I planned for your sake. I have just my magic to help right a great wrong done a long ago." And he said that after that, Prospero said, "No one is harmed in that storm." Actually, it was going on according to him what he has been planned. "Then what is wrong, father?" Miranda asked with a puzzled frown. She was surprised what was wrong, and she was being puzzled, means confused. "Enough," said Prospero. He moved his left hand in front of Miranda's face and she fell into enchanted sleep where she stood. When she questioned him what was wrong, Prospero, just what he did, he just removed his left hand and kept in front of her face, as he was a magician. And as soon as he kept his left hand in front of his face, she fainted asleep where she stood. She felt sleepy as he kept his hand in front of her face. Prospero took two paces towards the sea, looking out at the place where the ship had sunk. "Soon, my brother," he whispered. He just what he did, as soon as the Miranda felt sleep, he took two paces towards the sea, just where the ship was sinking. "Soon, my brother," he whispered. He told in his mouth, "Soon, come on, it is sinking." A sound made him turn his head in time to see a strange creature creeping up behind Miranda. And when he was just whispering something towards the sea, just he heard a sound and he turned his head, and this time he saw some strange creature which was creeping behind Miranda. It was shaped like a man. It was looking like a human being, a man, but its skin was covered with glistening green scales and its eyes were as yellow as lizards. He said that it was looking like a human being, but the body was not, or the skin was not like humans. On its body it was glistening green scales like we see for the fishes or snakes, and its eyes were as yellow as lizard. "Caliban," Prospero said sternly, "you brought no wood or water to cave this morning. Must I send the spirits to trouble you again?" It was a Caliban. Prospero said sternly, "You have not brought water or wood to the cave where he lives that morning. And so he is telling, shall I send the spirits to trouble you?" You know what are spirits? Like what we say, it's like an Atma, to a trouble for him. Caliban scowled in the sense, he looks angrily at Prospero. "You brought no wood or water to the cave this morning. I was not born to be your servant," he answered defiantly. When he said, "Why you have not run, shall I send some spirits to you?" Then Caliban answered him, "I am not your servant." In the way he shouted that, he was not obeying. This shows that the tone says that he was not obeying to the Prospero. "My mother, the great witch Sirox, promised me that I would rule this island, and so I would have if you had not come here and stolen her books of magic and freed her slave spirits to help you drive her way." He's telling that his mother name was Sirox, promised that would rule on this island, and if you had not come here and stolen the books of the magic and freed her slave spirits to help you drive her away. Silence, said Prospero, and he snapped his fingers. Needles of fire seemed to poke Caliban, forcing him his knees. Silence, said Prospero. When Caliban was telling that if you have not stolen the book of the magic of his mother and freed some of the slaves, so listening him, he said to keep silence, and forcing him to his knees, means making him to kneel down. Mercy, master, mercy, he cried, bowing his head. He just kneeled down on his knees and he was asking for the mercy. Have some pity on me. The pain left and he set his face so that Prospero would not see his cunning smile. He just wanted some mercy, and he said that Prospero could not see his cunning smile. Why are you so cruel? He whimpered. Whimper means make a low, weak, crying noise. You were kind to me once, and you repaid my kindness by trying to kidnap my daughter, snapped Prospero. Get to work, you treacherous wretch. This means just Prospero was telling for the Caliban that he was trying to kidnap for Miranda, and so he snapped Prospero, and he just said to get down to his work for the wretch. Treacherous wretch means just it was untrustworthy wretch. Caliban stood and shambled off. Shambled off means walked away, lazily dragging his feet along the ground. I will be revenged one day, he muttered to himself. Just when he was walking back lazily, he just muttered in his mouth that he is going to take an revenge. I will be the king of this island. I will take Miranda as my queen. Just while going, he muttered that he is going to take a revenge and he is going to make Miranda as his queen. When Caliban was safely out of sight, Prospero lifted his stuff. Aril, he called softly, appear to me now, sweet spirit. He just, when the Caliban went out, went away from there, Prospero again lifted his stuff, means his magic stick. And Aril, he called softly, appear to me now, sweet spirit. There was a faint sound of music, lights sparkled in the air, winking like sunshine on bursting bubbles. In the midst of the lightning fluttered a young boy with golden skin and white wings on his heels. He smiled at Prospero and darted playfully around his head. As he called the spirit, sweet spirit, there was a boy winking. There was a light sparkle in the air, winking like sunshine, and a young boy with who was having a golden skin with white wings, and even he was having a wings on his heels. He smiled at Prospero and darted playfully around his head. Prospero laughed faithfully. Errol, he said, are the sailors scattered over the island as I commanded? He just, as the boy came there, he just laughed and asked him, all the sailors have scattered over the island. Scattered means they have been gone here and there. They have been spread on that as he has been commanded. There are good masters, said Earl, his voice like the gentle humming of a harp. They are good. He just said that they are good, and his voice was gentle. And where is Fedren, the king of Naples, son? And he asked about the Fedren, the king of Naples, son. Prospero reminded, close by, said Errol. He mourns his father, believing him to be drowned. He is not drowned, said Prospero. He wanders the island, lost with my brother Antonio. Prospero sighed and told old memories, gave his face a far-off look. He just was asking about his father, who has been mourned mourn his father, believing him to be drowned. He said that he wandered the island and lost with my brother. He was wandering in the island with his brother Antonio, and which with his old memories gave his face a far off look. Means recalling all the old memories, they were having some good look on their face. 12 years ago, when I was Duke of Milan, my wife died. He was recalling the story of 12 years before, when I was the Duke of Milan. My wife died, he said sadly. Grief blended me to the trickery of Antonio, who plotted in secret with my old enemy. Plotted with his old enemy, and he was just in a grief pain as his wife was dead. King Alcino of Naples, they overthrew me and Antonio took my palace. Naples king have been thrown both the brothers out of the place. I was put in an open boat with my daughter and cast adrift to die. But destiny took me to this island, to Xerox magic book, and my spells brought the ship here, and now it's time for mischief and magic and revenge, master said Errol. Prospero shook his head. I do not seek revenge, only justice, he said. Go to the Prince Federin and bring him here. Prospero said that I don't want to take any revenge from the kings of the Naples, just he want the justice. Errol's eyes darkened into doubt. Will be as you promise, master. When your plan is done, will I be free? When he said that he wants justice, he promised. Will it be as you promised? He just promised him to be free him. Free as the wind, my Errol, said Prospero. I will break my spells and no magic will ever hold you again. He just wanted to keep the friend free it from the enemy. Errol glowed brightly and flew off faster than Prospero's eyes could follow. Errol glowed brightly and flew from there. Prince Federin was seated cross-legged on the sand. Cross-legged means keeping one upon the other leg. Salt water and the sun had bleached his brown hair almost blonde. Blonde means a pale gold in color. And his handsome face was lined with sadness. He was sitting in the salt water with a cross leg, and his face was lined with sadness. Whenever he closed his eyes, he saw the massive waves that had swallowed the ship and cast him upon this island. Just he was closing his eyes, he was seeing that swallowed means the ship was being vanished in the massive island. He might never be found, and he wondered if it would be better to swim out to sea and join the drowned father than face a life of miserable loneliness. He said that just as a ship went, he could have also been drowned into the water. It would be better facing the life in a miserable or loneliness. His thoughts were interrupted suddenly by lights dancing in front of his face. swarming like bees. Without a word, he followed where the lights led him. Prospero saw Federin from afar, flowing bewitched, placed under a magic spell. Behind Errol's glimmering lights, when the young prince was close by, Prospero touched Miranda on the shoulder, realizing her from the spell. Instantly, she woke, and the first thing she saw was Federin. "Is this a spirit, father?" she gasped. No, my child, it's a man of flesh and blood like you and me, Prospero told her. But I thought all men had white hair and beard like yours, Miranda exclaimed. As you know that Prospero, Miranda was being slept by his father when his father kept hand on front of her face, and when Prospero touched Miranda on his shoulder, realizing her from the spell. Then after waking up, she asked that the first thing she saw was, as soon as she opened her eyes, she saw Fedren, and she asked for her father whether it is a spirit. Then the father told that it was not a spirit, it's like just a body with flesh and blood. And she told that she thought that it's like a man like white hair and beard like his father. Just so, children, so this part is very big. Let us continue the tempest in the second part.